There's very little that gives an artist more pleasure than when someone praises one of his artistic masterpieces. And there's very little that pleases a son more than when someone speaks highly of his mother. And we know that the Lord is the same. He is overjoyed when we speak of his greatest masterpiece, who is also his mother. And so now we'd like to, in this month of Mary, to give praise to the great masterpiece of the master artist.
There is a woman
whose beauty and wisdom exceeds all creation,
whose yes changed the whole course of history,
who emanates the light that illumines the darkness,
because this light is the light of God himself, whom she carries within her.
Do you know her? There is a star
that shines in the darkness and leads us safely to our eternal home.
That brightens a world often darkened by hatred, fear, and despair.
That brings the light of joy and peace to our night skies.
Does this star light your life?
There is a lover
who loves without limits, boundaries, or conditions,
and teaches her children to do so too.
Who loved even in the midst of great suffering.
Who gives herself away as a gift to God and all her children.
Do you know her love?
There is a warrior
whose strength surpasses the mightiest of warriors,
because it is the strength of God himself who lives within her.
Who fiercely protects all those who live under her mantle.
Who vanquished the enemy of her children.
Are you fighting on her side?
There is a queen whose splendor reaches beyond the heavens,
whose rule is one of gentle tenderness
instead of power and beauty.
Who reigns because she served.
Is she your queen?
There is a mother
who covers her children with her tender and maternal love,
who consoles her children with her presence,
who is attentive to all their needs even when they don't see it themselves,
who is by their side, even in the midst of the greatest sufferings,
who never abandons them, even in the most difficult moments.
Are you her child?
A deep connection with Mary because she was my confirmation saint, and we also share a name. My real name's Mary Ann, so it was cool for me to always have the same name as Mary and her mother. And I always just thought it was amazing that Mary was able to say yes to God and do what he wanted without even thinking about herself. She just was amazing.
Hi, I'm Randy Simmons, the proud principal at Peoria Notre Dame High School. And I was asked to speak about my relationship with Mary. This week I had a tragic event happen. I lost a very dear friend on Wednesday morning, and I struggled with this, as I'm still struggling with it, which is normal in death, I understand. But oftentimes we find that our faith gets tested. And I found Wednesday, when I found out about my very good friend dying, I was a bit of an emotional wreck, to be honest with you, for a while. And after I kind of regrouped myself, I found myself praying to not only Jesus, but Mary. And I felt her comfort, felt her arms wrapped around me, and her spirit with me during these tough times, as I'm still going through those. But I find a lot of great comfort with knowing that she supports me through all the times. And when our faith does get questioned, as it does in death, that it is comforting to know that she's there for us. Her love has truly allowed me to get through this. So with that short anecdotal story, I just want to remind everybody to these times come up, pray hard, pray often, and know that Jesus and his mother are always with us, and they get us through the tough times. Thank you.
Hi, my name's JT, and Mary has impacted my life in a great way. And because of Mary, I actually became Catholic. I wasn't Catholic for a long time, but I played football for Notre Dame JFL, and they all prayed the Hail Mary before every game, and it made me wonder why they were praying to Mary. So that prayer actually led me to become Catholic. So that's how she's impacted my life.
The reason I love Mary is a very personal reason, and it's because I lost my mom when I was 6 years old, and I really didn't know what to think until I started looking into Pope John Paul II, and he sort of adopted Mary as his mother, and so ever since then, which I was about 10 or 11 when I found that out, I have tried to do the same. To bring Mary to be my mother as well.
So my name is Mrs. Hausauer, and I'd like to talk today about my devotion to Mary. I became devoted to Mary more strongly back in college when I went on a Marian pilgrimage to Fatima and Lourdes, and it was just a very moving trip to spend time in the places where Mary has actually visited, especially children. And now that I'm a mother, I truly see Mary as my own mother. When I'm sitting up with a crying child in the middle of the night who's gotten up three times, I think I pray to Mary, Mary, did you have to do this with Jesus? Was Jesus a brat at times? Did Jesus wake up three times a night and demand to be fed or demand to be carried and held and cried and cried and cried? So now that I'm a mother and I have those experiences myself, I really spend my nights praying to Mary. Having her sit with me while I am rocking a crying child to sleep. So she's a very special mother in my life.
Mary has been a shining example for me as a mother and loving person, and her endurance in watching her son die and going through all that pain has really inspired me in my life. And when I face struggles, such as homework or the challenges that accompany running, I can always look to her for an example of persistence and being able to get through challenges that come in the way. And sometimes when I run, I'll just repeat a Hail Mary or a Memorare so that I just always feel her presence. And I know that her love is always available to me when I need it.
My name is Matt Blackford. I'm the athletic director here at Peoria Notre Dame. And I just wanted to share my devotion to Mary and my experiences with Mary. You know, she's our church's mother, and I feel like she is my mother as well. And I'm always asking Mary to pray for me because I know that she's there, and I know that good sons always listen to their mothers. And my experience is that when my mother needs something for the nuns at the soup kitchen, when they want something, they never call me. They have my mom call me and say, hey, we need a bus, or we need Mr. Blackford to take us to this place. And I always do it because my mother asked me to do it. And I feel the same way about Mary, that if I need something Jesus or God, then I just ask Mary to pray for me, and I ask her for her help. There's probably not a day that goes by that I don't say Hail Mary. And I tell people I always have a rosary. I've got 10 fingers, so I can pray it whenever, when I'm driving a bus, when I'm driving my car. It's a peaceful time for me to be able to say the rosary and to feel close to Mary and feel like she's helping me and that she's got her arm around me. I guess I'm highly motivated by Mary in terms of how she lived her life, not only Mary, but also just the Holy Family, Joseph as well, in terms of faith, you know, to do what she did in her life and the faith that she showed to become the Mother of God, had to be very, very scary. So when I'm sometimes troubled by my faith or what I have to do, I sometimes think about Mary saying yes to God and It just helps me to get through those things.
Hi, my name is Beth Salmon, and I work up in the finance department at Peoria Notre Dame. I have always had a deep love and affection and devotion to the Blessed Mother, and I've always had a knowing that she is with me. I have many experiences in my life that affirm that to me, but I want to share one in particular. About 5 years ago, Matt and I went to one of the meetings in February. The speaker that night happened to be a priest from Austria that founded an order of priests that were devoted to Mary. The real thesis of his talk that night was about all the grace that comes from suffering. One of the things he began to say was that when someone loses a child, they suffer deeply. Well, my husband and I looked at each other because we have lost a child. We lost our third daughter. Years ago. So we looked at each other and thought, okay, we probably needed to be there, knew of the deep suffering that comes from losing a child. Then Father went on to say that when you have a child that has special needs, that you suffer greatly. Well, Matt and I looked at each other again because our fourth daughter has a seizure disorder and has caused some neurological problems, and she has special needs. So we looked at each other and we knew that we needed to be there that night. So we were grateful that we were there. And Father went on to talk about all the graces, which we agree come from suffering. So at the end of the night, on our way out, we wanted to thank Father for the talk. And we went up to him, and Father took my hand, and he looked in my eyes, and he said, I know you have suffered deeply. Well, he didn't know our story. He had no idea about our losses and our suffering with our daughters. So I shared with him a little bit about that. He asked about my other daughters. I told him we had, you know, the four daughters there. So that would be the end of the story, except that 2 months later in April, I was driving down the driveway. I come in the house and Matt said, there's a package for you from Germany. And I was like, Germany? So I opened it up, and inside the package was a note from Father Paul to me with four miraculous medals that had been blessed by the Pope for each of my daughters. But what he doesn't know is that I wear a miraculous medal that someone gave me that was blessed by St. John Paul, that someone gave me after Sarah died. No one would ever know that. So that was just one more affirmation to me that the Blessed Mother is always with me. And the lessons that she has taught me is that humble acceptance of God's will always, and to seek Him always in everything that I do.
When I think of Mary, I think of just sheer love. I smile when I think of her because her fiat was so great and so pure and honest and without doubt. And I have difficulties with saying yes or accepting the problems that go on in my life every day. Mary has always answered every prayer or every trouble that has come across my life. And I always can rely on her. Like, for instance, when I had a family member pass away, I didn't know what to do, so I went directly to the church and just sat there and sat in front of her statue. I lit a candle. And just being there, right there at that moment, I could feel her love being upon me and trying to heal my soul and also my family's. Mary's intercession is so great, and we take it so much for granted, too, but I always know that her love is always there for me, and it's there for you as well.
St. Louis de Montfort told us that the surest, easiest, and best way to the heart of Jesus is through the heart of Mary. And this only makes sense since it is through Mary that Jesus came to us. So we too return to Jesus in the way that He Himself established. So we simply encourage you to not forget and treasure the Lord's greatest gift that He gave to us, and His last and final gift that He gave to us from the cross, and His Mother. She is a consoler, an advocate, an intercessor, but more than anything, she is also our teacher, our guide, and our mother, who knows her Son's heart more than anyone else and leads us always directly to Him.